So you have a nice house, you put a lot of love and attention into it, you thought you priced it right, you hired a real estate agent, it sat on the market, and bang, your listing's dead. It's not in the MLS, it didn't sell, you either didn't have offers or the one you got were just not acceptable, right? So I get that, and I'm not here to try to beat up your last agent. What I'm here to tell you is that over the last 25 years, I have made part of my practice, in fact, my number one sales opportunity has always been working with home sellers like you, identifying what went wrong with the listing. I mean, it's kind of easy because you can look back and see what was done, what the photography looked like, the pricing, the way the house was presented. And you know, that didn't work, right? So we already start with opportunity. We know what didn't work, so we don't do that again, right? We don't make the same mistake twice. But then we look at the market and say, what is the market saying about this home? And then we figure out, what can we do the other agent didn't? And usually the answers are pretty clear. We do professional photography. We do a presentation of that photography that's far different than the homes around it that puts your home in the best light to sell. We make sure the pricing's right. Usually the pricing isn't the problem. It's usually not pricing, it's presentation and marketing. And the other thing I think that's missing is the fact that we're no longer a real estate industry, and I'm really not a real estate agent. I'm a tech agent. I'm a technical assistant, so to speak, to the sale of your home. Now, we're in real estate, of course, but selling homes today is a technical process. There are people online shopping on Zillow, Realtor.com, and Trulia, which represent roughly 70% of all home searches, right? So if I get that part right, I have a 7 in 10 chance of reaching everybody. But here's the problem. Zillow, Trulia, and Realtor.com trick people. They don't show you everything. Some listings aren't at the top. Some listings get pressed down, and there's a lot of ways to trick those systems to get your home to the top. I know how to do all that. That's why you hire me. But more importantly, as they're shopping on those websites, there are other vendors out there, some of which are the companies we pay to help us market homes, that are, I hate to put it this way, but spying on home searches. And those people have unique little cookie identifiers on their web browsers, most people do. And so what we want to do is buy that data from those companies, from those searches, and we want to take your house and we want to put it in their social media feeds. When they go to the Wall Street Journal or NBC or the Drudge Report or their favorite news channel's website or whatever they like to, they may be a hunter and they're reading a hunting magazine online, and we want to put a little box ad with your house, with pictures of it, getting them to our website so we can get their information and show your home. Now the question really is, did your agent do this? Did you ever hear about this? Using tracking devices that are perfectly normal and legal, even if a little creepy, to find people looking for homes just like yours around your house, and then making sure that your house appears everywhere they are online in box ads and social media ads. They click on those things and it allows us to do the job you've hired us to do, which is aggressively sell your house. Now, there's a whole lot more to this process than that, but that's a simple way of looking at what the tech industry has done to change real estate over the last decade and how we provide you as a home seller through our efforts all of the tools you need to ensure that your next listing with me doesn't end up expired or withdrawn and you upset and wondering, why did my house not sell? I don't ever want someone to have that question after working with me, and it's almost never that it's happened in my real estate career of 25 years and selling over 2,000 listings. And I look forward to the opportunity, no obligation, to sit down and help you understand what it will take to sell your house and for how much money you can expect from the home sale. HouseDog.com, you can do a free evaluation of your home's value there. But more importantly, let me do it for you manually and in person. It's going to be far more reliable and accurate that way. HouseDog.com. Thanks a lot.